and we go to the Arctic, we dress up to survive a winter storm. Rifles to protect ourselves against polar bears. It's the same thing with the Arctic World Archive.
Deep in the permafrost of Svalbard lies the Arctic World Archive. Like its neighbor, the Global Seed Vault, the Arctic World Archive aims to protect the most essential pieces of human culture from the chaos of the external world. That means art, literature, and code.
In the next 1,000 years, there will be no major invention where software doesn't play a role. We think it's important to preserve knowledge of open source development for future generations.
From phone operating systems to digital payment platforms, open source software has had a huge influence in our everyday lives. Here's how GitHub and the Arctic World Archive have partnered to preserve that code for the future.
GitHub is an online platform for software developers. Repos include Linux, Android, Ruby, Bitcoin, and then, you know, projects from all around the world. We had the epiphany that we wanted to preserve that knowledge in an archive.
We interact with the open source code housed on GitHub every day. These pieces of code are an essential, but often invisible, part of modern culture. And like other big tech companies, GitHub backs up this code in data centers around the world. But hard drives are susceptible to failure or data loss. So Thomas asked Piql, the company who runs the Arctic World Archive, to devise a more permanent solution for the valuable code. Their answer, film.
We have converted film into a modern digital information carrier. This is a piece of Piql film. It's a silver halide film. We convert files into light, a sequence of photons that's exposing the film, because film is light sensitive. You cannot really see it with your bare eye, it's just a gray field. But once you put it under the microscope, you see it's actually individual pixels building up that super high resolution QR code.
The first few frames on these film reels contain tiny, readable print in 5 languages that provide clear instructions on how to convert the QR codes back into usable files. All that a future human would need to reconstruct the archive is a computer, a camera, and a light source.
We choose the location of the Arctic World Archive because it's really remote.
Longyearbyen, Svalbard is the northernmost settlement in the world with a population of less than 3,000 people. It's most famous for a building down the road from the Arctic World Archive, the Global Seed Vault, which aims to preserve plant genetic material, much like the AWA aims to preserve human culture. International treaties and the cold, dry permafrost protect the contents of the vaults from the outside world.
The vault itself is located 300 meters down in a decommissioned coal mine. It's literally protected by polar bears. So you don't walk around without a rifle. Inside the vault today, there is manuscripts from the Vatican Library, Brazilian football history. Once upon a time, Brazil had a good national soccer team. So it's good to keep the memories from the good and glorious days. Opera, classical music, rock music. The Bible is there.
And of course, open source code from GitHub.
We did the initial drop of the most popular open source repos on just one film reel. It was super cold, it was dark all day, but it was also very exciting to be there.
And this year, Piql wrote every open source GitHub repo with at least 250 stars onto film reels and deposited them in the vault for perpetuity.
I remember, you know, buying my first Linux distribution at a bookstore in Berlin, Germany, and now open source is everywhere. Software is such an important piece of our life that I'm personally motivated to preserve it for future generations.
The Arctic World Archive, it's meant to be not only for my kids, but for my grandchildren. The world is developing extremely fast. There are events that have happened that we should bring to the future so we can learn to make good decisions.
In the same way that you might find an old book in a library that opens your eyes of, you know, how things were. You know, in 1,000 years, hopefully there's still humans on Earth, and we want to tell them, you know, that we deeply care about open source collaboration and we want to preserve that for future generations to come.
Hey, thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, share it with a friend. And check out freethink.com for more stories of people moving the world.